الحمد لله وصفا وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى أما بعد Honorable President, respected judges, and dear all.
Today on this auspicious occasion, it's my pleasure to say some word on the topic of Prophet Muhammad on peace and social justice. Dear audience, the world today is far from modesty. Political factions and all sort of social and economic discrimination have segmented the human race. Injustice is very widespread on this earth. There can be no peace without the firm establishment of justice. The more you see injustice, the more you realize the importance of establishing justice in the land. When mankind lacks guidance on how to live their lives, the entire structure of society is damaged. Allah subhanahu has sent down the Quran as guidance to all mankind. With all the rules and regulation, we need to stay on the right track. Islam is a very complete way of life. Every rule that is good for humanity has been ordained in the Sharia of Allah. Everything we need in order to live successfully can be found in the Quran. Amongst these very important divinely instructed laws is the law of establishing justice. The Quran attaches great value to peace. Peace at the expense of justice is not acceptable to the Quran. These two issues, peace and justice, are not correlated but complementary to each other. Allah says in the Quran, Surah Nahl, chapter number 16, verse number 19. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. Allah commands justice, the doing of good, and liberality to kith and kin, and He forbids all shameful deeds, injustice and rebellion. He instructs you that you may receive admonition. Dear audience, establishing justice is the law of Allah. It is part of the balance which has created as justice lead to the peace in the society. The essence of justice is the recognition that all humans are equal, and it means creating harmony. Once we accept the principle of human equality, then we need to reject all racism, nationalism, and ethnocentrism. This is something some people find difficult to accept, but that is only remedy leading us toward justice and peace. Dear audience, the Medina Charter, written and promulgated by Prophet Muhammad for the multi-religious, 10,000 strong citizens of the city-state of Medina in 622 AD, is truly a remarkable political constitutional document. The claim made by Professor Muhammad Hamidullah that it was the first written constitution in the world is not without basis. Aristotle's Constitution of Athens, written on papyrus, discovered by an American missionary in Egypt in 1819 and published in 1891, was not constitution, but it was an account of the constitution of the city-state of Athens. Dear audience, the Constitution of Medina, which Prophet drew up with the multi-religious community of Medina soon after his arrival there, remains a shining model for communities that strive for social justice to this day. It was a magnificent and historical document authored and dictated by Prophet Muhammad. This document secured and promoted cooperation and alliance among all people of any creed, color, ethnicity, and lineage, and it set down the criterion of righteousness as the basis of distinction. It also guaranteed the freedom of worship to all religious communities, and the spirit evidence there shone into the heart of all the followers of the Prophet. That is the spirit of equity, tolerance, and understanding. The Prophet insisted that the lack of tolerance toward the non-Muslims under Islamic rule is a grave offense. This agreement between the first Muslim community and Jewish community in Medina shows the sense of justice portrayed in the Prophet's character in dealing with minorities. It also clearly shows that the Prophet did not respect Islam, even the city of Medina, by force. On the contrary, he promoted peaceful coexistence with followers of other faiths, especially Jewish and Christian. Let it be known, if any Muslim commits injustice, insults, mistreats, or abuses a person of the people of the book protected by the state or agreement, he will have to answer me for his immoral action on the day of judgment. Dear audience, the Quranic instruction regarding the maintenance of justice when dealing with the enemies is noteworthy. Allah says in the Quran, Surah Al-Ma'idah, chapter number 5, verse number 8, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُونُوا قَوَّامِينَ لِلَّهِ شُهَدَاءَ بِالْقِسْطِ وَلَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَآنُ قَوْمٍ عَلَىٰ أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا اعْدِلُوا هُوَ أَقْرَبُ لِلتَّقْوَى وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. O you who believe, be maintainers of justice and bear of witness for the sake of Allah. Let not hatred of a people incite you to act unjustly. Be just, this near to righteousness. And fear Allah, surely Allah is aware of what you do. Here I end up my speech. وآخر دعوانا عن الحمد لله رب العالمين.